Hello everybody, this is ManuS and welcome to another Artifact news episode. So earlier, massive news just dropped. There is going to be another big patch in Artifact and the patch just happened. So let's take a look at what's up with that patch. Okay, so we got skill rating, leveling and balance changes. So first off, we get a way to level our account. So leveling our account actually gives us a set number of tickets and packs, so you now can get some fixed amount of product just from playing. So they kind of try to find the middle ground between not undermining the economy system while still giving people a bit to work for. So this is actually a pretty good and smart move, I think. This basically just kind of effectively increases the amount you get from the initial purchase of the account. You get your 10 packs, your 5 tickets, and also the amount of tickets and packs that you get from this leveling system. I so far couldn't find yet what number of tickets and packs we are getting, but that honestly isn't too important to me. I think it's just nice that there is something to work towards now, and the fact that this is kept and kind of just basically part of what you pay for, it doesn't strongly affect the economy or undermine the economy, which is a great choice, but still gives people something to work towards and something that gives them a bit more of a buffer before they potentially have to spend extra money. So that's pretty nice. And then we have an implementation of skill rating. You basically I'll talk about the skill rating in a moment because there's a section about that further below. First, let's talk about the card changes. So initially, they wanted to do it very paper-like and change cards only if absolutely necessary, but they saw that people care about balance more than anything, and the immutability of assets is only secondary, and that it's more important that the game is good, and the immutability of assets will kind of follow suit, and yeah, more people playing the game will also positively affect assets. Also, some cards being cheaper means other cards become more expensive, so there's just kind of like a shift in value rather than just loss of value. But let's look at the changes. So first change, not too surprising, X got changed. Interesting change, they changed the base stats from 7 to 11 to 6 to 10, which puts him much closer to Keefe. Like, basically, he's a Keefe that has 2 armor instead of 11 health. So it's like 1 health point down, 1 armor point up, which is still a bit better, but now the base stats are not much better than Keefe, which is kind of big. That makes him much worse at Berserker's Calling. It makes him worse at killing heroes. Now a lot of heroes survive. Drow Ranger survives it. Zeus survives it. Ogre Magi survives it. Like, all these blue heroes that he before just kind of like hit over the head. He also becomes a bit worse at killing certain heroes over multiple turns. He still kills some heroes, like Solar Khan, but for example, he doesn't kill Bounty Hunter anymore, so that's also a relevant one. So yeah, this is quite a big change. His signature card is still amazing and he's still one of the top red heroes. Curious how it's gonna affect the metagame and the decks he's in. I don't think there's much of a replacement for him. Sure, his stats are worth, but his signature card is where his real value lies, in my opinion, and that is still powerful, and the other red heroes are still worth, so he's still gonna be like one of the top red heroes. But I guess in some decks that only have 2 red heroes and that don't care about Berserker's Call as much and want the red hero more for the beefiness, I think it's going to be a closer decision now between Axe and Bristleback potentially, because Legion Commander is still premium. Also because Bristleback potentially plays better with Legion Commander, because Bristleback is a better dual target than Axe now, because Axe just doesn't kill that much stuff with dual. Okay. Onto the next change. Next change is Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker stats change from 7-6 to 7-7, which in turn means he doesn't die to the new X, which is actually pretty big, then other than that, I think the 7th health doesn't do a whole lot. There's not a whole lot of like 6th attack heroes in the game, so that shouldn't change too much. But just having a bit more stats, I guess, is nice. The change to the signature spell is fairly big. Blood Rage, now costing 4 instead of 5, is really nice. Makes the card much more useful and feel much more properly priced in terms of mana cost. Before, at 5, the card was just clunky and overcosted, especially in comparison to Gust, but we'll talk about Gust later, because as you might have guessed, it's also on the list. Anyway, Bloodseeker, at least in Limited, is now a much more playable unit. I think he's close to on at the level of like base hero now. Debbie is still probably a bit better, but the card is now a real consideration, especially in a deck where you already have one Debbie. Now Bloodseeker might be a real alternative over the second Debbie alongside the first Debbie, for example, that sort of stuff. But it's still not a great hero, probably. The 7-7 is still like pretty awkward stats, like 7 attack on a black hero. It's just a pretty tiny hero, and the ability and the signature card is better, but still not great, I think. But let me know in the comments what you guys think. This is another very big change. Cheating Death, the most unfun and annoying card in the game, arguably, gets changed again. So I think the card used to cost 4 in the beta at some point, from what I heard. Now it costs 4 again, so that's a buff first. But the text drastically changed. Now it's an active with a cooldown of 1. You can use it once a turn. And you give a unit a death shield this round, and it still may only be used if you have a green hero in this lane. So now you can save one unit guaranteed, rather than every unit having a 50% death shield. So that's kind of nice, but obviously the fact that it's an active means that, yeah, this can be outmaneuvered with initiative and upkeep kill stuff. But on the upside, it now guaranteed saves the thing you want to save. While before, you always kind of like had to hope that the thing that you don't want to die survive. And now you can make sure that the one thing you want to die the least and is most important, you can just save with the active. And you can do that once a turn. So still an interesting card, not the like obnoxious coin flipping powerhouse it used to be before, that frustrates both players, but was too good to not play in the end. So we'll have to see what the plays in Constructed will be of the card. I think the card is not bad, but it's definitely less impactful and more situational and specific. So I'm curious to see how it's gonna pan out. But the fact that it now costs 4, it can, for example, come down on the second turn and prevent a trade over 2 turns that started on the first turn and stuff like that. So there are still like strong things it can do, just not sure if that's what you care about in Constructed and in what decks you care about it. It is definitely a card to keep in mind and try to like rethink where its place is and how it works. Next we have Draw Ranger. The only change to Draw Ranger is to Gust. Now instead of silencing all enemy heroes this round, it silences an enemy hero and its allied neighbors this round. So you can sort of play around Gust a bit by making sure your heroes aren't too clumped together. Otherwise, they could get multi-silenced by Draw Ranger still. Also keep in mind it can only target a hero. So if there's a hero, a creep, and a hero, they cannot go silence the creep and both heroes to the side of it. They can only silence the hero and the creeps to the side of it. So it is significantly worse. The signature card is basically, I would say, as bad or even worse than Bloodseeker's signature card. Draw is still pretty powerful due to the aura that it provides, but in Constructed, I think Gust was the bigger part of Draw and its dominance. Gust was one of the cards that a lot of games and strategies kind of revolved around or got beaten by, and turns in games decided by. Basically just kind of like time walking your opponent and just deciding that they cannot do anything meaningful anymore for the entire turn, or like the entire turn in this lane, was so powerful. It allowed decks like the blue-green combo deck to just have free reign, go nuts, do all the things, and so on, without being stopped. Now this is going to be a lot harder. You can just try and kill the Incarnation, for example, or Hero after they start, after they attempt to go off, and so on. It also worked from the other side to secure kills like green-red ramp decks, just gusting to make sure you don't get annihilated, and then just winning the lane and stuff like that. So gust not doing all these things anymore is a massive game changer, and I'm curious to see how the meta game shakes out. This should be the single biggest change if you ask me to constructed and the constructed meta game, because this card was so defining and so kind of oppressive at how it affected the game, that it no longer doing that and just turning into like a better version of Rick's signature card is an incredibly big change, and hard to imagine how the ripple effects of this will go long term. Next we have an interesting change, an item. Jasper Daggers. Gold cost went from 7 to 5, which makes a lot of sense. Like, I mean, Demagicking Maul cost 5 and had a more meaningful effect that also could generate card advantage. So Jasper Daggers costing 7 was just like ridiculously overcosted, so 5 is a good change. But that's not where the change ends. We get an additional bonus, a new keyword, equip effect. You purge your opponent's effects from equipped hero. So that makes the card a lot better. Might now even become interesting to consider as like a one-off in some item decks, more for the purge effect than for the pierce effect. But the pierce effect is a nice upside, basically. And it becomes a really, really good situational secret shop role at this point, because it can do some really powerful things between the pierce and the purge, or both even mattering, and that for only 5 gold. So that's a pretty cool change, made the item very interesting and relevant in various ways. Then we have a change to Lion, another hero that was kind of on the fringes. I thought in Limited he was quite decent, but a bit like fragile and yeah, kind of like close to Debbie depending on how late game oriented your deck was. The new ability basically does the same, except it also quickens, which is a new keyword. Quickens means you reduce the cooldown by 1, but not below 1. Seems like this is a permanent change, so basically now Lion is a true late game monster in a way, because the ability now ramps up its cooldown in a way that I think the initial version is 4, then it goes to 3, to 2, and then to 1. So you, after a while in the super late game, you can just use it every turn, which is really powerful. And also, it's fine, because at that stage, not a whole lot of heroes are dying to 8 piercing damage anymore, unless they took a massive amount of damage already, making this just scale nicely into the late game. Still a bit awkward, because the mana drain card is such an early game tempo play, and the hero is such a late game hero in terms of its ability and body, that still kind of causes problems for Lion, I think. But an interesting thing to keep in mind is that Lion's mana drain is actually kind of the closest now that we have to the old Gust in a way, because for effectively 0 mana, you can at least force the opponent to kind of skip their turn this turn. Obviously it works more as a tempo play and against curve plays, and less against the super powerful turns that I mentioned that Draw Ranger could also protect or set up. But it is interesting to keep in mind and makes this card a bit more unique and appealing, I guess. Still probably not enough to make it into Constructed usually, but in Limited, this guy definitely got a bunch better. Then we have Outworld Devourer, arguably the worst hero in the game. It got a little less bad now, it's a 4-7 instead of a 4-6, making it a bit more durable, making it survive, for example, the new X and Keyfear and stuff. And also, yeah, just kind of line up a bit better. I still think the hero is pretty bad and pretty unplayable. I would not put it in my draft deck, let alone my anywhere near my constructor deck. Next, we have another pretty cool change. Timbersaw got a nice buff. In addition to its plus one armor for each of its attackers, each of Timbersaw's attackers now has minus one armor, which works particularly well with his signature card that then deals 3 damage to its attackers. Keep in mind, it only works against its attackers, so if the enemy neighbors are not flanking him, it's only gonna give the minus one armor to the one hero he is fighting. But that effectively gives him a better version of 5 attack. Before, his 4 attack was pretty low. Now he effectively has a better version of 5 attack that synergizes with his signature card and some other stuff. So that's pretty nice, making this an even better potential alternative to Keefy in draft decks. Before, it was kind of like, in a bit more late game oriented defensive decks, and a decent alternative to Keefy, and now it just got quite a bunch better, and in general I think becomes a bit more appealing of a hero. But it's not that big of a buff, but it's the kind of card that was fine before and now is even a bit more appealing. Okay, on to the new features that we talked about. The skill rating goes from 1 to 75. The skill rating is specific to a particular time period and game mode and ranges from 1 to 75. It's kind of an interesting range. And once you've earned a rating, it will not decrease this season. Every matchmaking game outside of the Call to Arms featured event contributes to skill rating adjustments. I don't think we know yet what like how long the seasons are, if they're going to be a month or how they work, but we'll learn that in the coming days, the latest, I think. We also got account levels and unlocks, as I mentioned. Every matchmaking game grants experience that contributes to account level. Increasing account level unlocks portraits and a number of event tickets and card packs. Then the new keywords, quicken and equip effect, which are two nice keyword additions. And then we just got some bug fixes. So it seems like 75 is the top of the of the skill rating, and 1 is where it starts. 1 to 75 is a pretty big range, but we also don't know how quickly and how extremely it progresses. But you can see your skill rating in each game mode underneath the game mode to get an idea what your skill rating is. Okay, these are a lot of cool changes, a lot of pretty big changes, but yeah, I'm pretty excited for these. Seems like Valve are really putting their heads together and thinking of good ways to implement things that people have been asking for in a smart way that makes sense within the game and doesn't undermine what they had set out for the game and they are doing. And yeah, and really trying to improve the game constantly, which is great, and that hopefully will make the game go up in popularity again and people give it more of a fair shake, because I think the game is great and it's only getting better with patches like this. So yeah, can't wait to see how the buffs and nerfs gonna shake out, and especially how this affects the constructed metagame. All right, and that's it again for today. This was the latest artifact news with the new patch. The build your legend update, as they call it. As usual, I will link the patch notes in the description below for you guys to check out. And oh, one important thing that I forgot before moving on. They will buy back all the cards that they changed for the peak price that they had on the market in the 24 hours before the announcement of this patch. Which means they will buy them back. Like, they go to Valve, they don't go on the market. So you can sell back your axes and drows and stuff that you bought on the market for constructed, and get your money back, which is a very generous offer and pretty great, because the cards will inevitably tank, so you can sell them to Valve and buy them from the market for cheaper to basically make up for the money you lost in the process, which is pretty nice. And interestingly, they even offer this for the commons and uncommons they buffed, which are like 5 cents peak value, and they were buffs. So that is kind of interesting, I guess. But yeah, I think the important ones are going to be extra and cheating deaths. Everything else is 5 cents. Alright, now we're really done. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Make sure to hit the like button below. Let me know in the comments what you think of the patch and the changes and how you think these will affect Constructed especially. And make sure to hit the subscribe button. Turn on the notification icon to not miss out on future content. Also follow me on Twitter and Facebook and Twitch to catch me live streaming. And yeah, that's it again for this time. I'm your host, ManuS. I thank you for watching. I hope to see you next time. Bye.